Hello everyone, this is Spec, the owner of the Funky Monks Discord server. You should definitely join. I'm here with Sephir, and we're going to rank every single Red Hot Chili Peppers song. Almost every single one, because Unlimited Love and the B-sides are missing from this list. We're gonna rank Unlimited Love after we ranked all of those. It'll stream real quick. Alright. Sex Rap, we already had a recording before, but we got interrupted and we had to like restart everything now. So we're gonna go through a lot of the first few rows. We're gonna go through them much quicker because we already had ranked them before. I think we had Sex Rap at C-. Yeah, that's an awful song. Black Eyed Blonde. Was that B+ or A-?
I think B+.
Yeah, that fits better. It's like, it's so much better live than on the studio.
Yeah.
Even You Brutus is, for me personally, also B+. I think it's a very underrated song. I Could Die For You, also B+. And it's like all, I enjoy all of those, like, the same amount, kinda. I like I Could Die For You the most out of all of these two. If, I forgot what I ranked If. What would you rank If?
It was low. I think it was C-, probably. But I agree with the C-.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I mean, I think the lyrics are amazing, but the instrumental is fucking boring. And
yeah.
It's really innovative, but it's like, just because it's something new doesn't mean it's good.
Yeah.
If you have to ask, this is so strong live that I'm gonna put it an A-. Like, how they cover Funkadelic live at the end and everything. The studio version of this song is alright, but how they play it live just like boosts it up.
Yeah, I agree.
Goodbye Angels, one of the better Getaway songs.
Yeah.
Would probably.
Last time we were.
Yeah.
We were talking about like how the Getaway is kind of like a B-tier mm-hmm. up in that area album.
Yep.
So putting it right there is agreeable.
I would put it in B+ because I enjoy it like
yeah.
exactly the
B+
same. Like in
cool.
Oh, hello.
Yeah.
Hello.
So we have been joined by another person. are you sure you want to talk? Because I'm recording this.
I might just need to be really quiet.
Okay.
So I won't talk much.
Okay. We'll enjoy your company, okay. Me and my friends, I think I had this in B-. Because
yeah.
the song itself is like really overplayed. I mean, it's good, but like it's really overplayed. It's just not
yeah.
that good. Backwoods for me is an A. Probably my favorite Uplift from UFO
yeah.
Party Plan song. The guitar is amazing. I really like how they go heavy in that one.
Yeah.
Californication. Maybe C+.
I think it'd be minus.
You know, like right there, but like around that area. I just think this is one of the weaker songs off of Californication.
Yeah, definitely. Just because it's so good live because of that intro they always do, that I'm
mm-hmm.
debating if I should put it in B, but it's like so overplayed and I cannot hear those 5 minutes of hardcore soft porn anymore that I just have to put it in C+. Subway to Venus, we discussed this last time. We both thought this was one of the weaker Mother Smoke songs.
I think it is, yeah.
No way.
Yeah, I think this is a really forgettable song. There are a few songs on this album that just sound really similar to each other. And, I don't know. I don't really like Anthony's vocals on this one at all. The outro is cool, though. I just remembered the outro. That boosts the song up a little. I think I might put it in above Counter-Verdication. Warped. Easy
Warped A. A+, yeah.
I would put
right
it
there.
In A, in my opinion. There's like better songs from
yeah, fair enough.
Factory of Faith, also easy A. I enjoyed that one even more than
yes.
Warped. Even though I'm With You is not my favorite album, I think the bassline of this song is so amazing and so memorable, and I really love playing this song in bass. That it's just so good. And I don't even listen to it often, it's just a good song. Car of Quality. Okay, Lane, do you like this song? Because me and Sephir both kind of agreed that this song is not the best on the album.
It's not the best, but it's not the worst either, in my opinion.
Yeah, so...
B-tier?
Yeah. B tier. It's like too long. We discussed this in the previous recording. It's like too long, but it's still really solid. It's like B is just like solid. The P, this song I never skip. Not even because it's just a silly 1 minute song, just because I actually enjoy the melody kinda.
I think it's I listened to it before and I think it was like good compared to what people meme it for.
Yeah, I think it's in itself, it's actually a really catchy song. It's just like a little fun flea song. I don't know. It's just like this A plus for me is songs that I usually never skip, and for some reason I just never skip P.
Yeah.
I don't know. Detroit. Oh yeah, this wasn't this is a controversial one. I would put it in B minus. I think that's the right place.
Yeah.
Everyone hates it for the verses, but I really I mean everyone hates it for the chorus, but I really hate it for the verse, and I think the chorus is really interesting. Oh god, someone skipped the song. We're gonna come to this one later. Let me just skip the at least interesting instrumental trick. Okay, here we go. Okay, The Righteous and the Wicked. Did we stop ranking here? No, we didn't. Righteous and the Wicked. This intro is really cool. We discussed that in the previous recording.
Yeah.
But it's just another song that just goes on for too long.
I think it would go in B minus, I reckon.
Yeah, I see it as a... Yeah, I see it as a high B minus song. That's a good way to rank it. Desecration Smile. Oh fuck, what did we rank this one?
We ranked it kind of...
What did he say? My internet lagged.
Yeah, it's like a B last time, I think.
I'm not sure. It's like a song I skip, but when I get around to listening to it, it's just like... I don't know, I think B minus. I'm just gonna put it in B tier because I think the history this song has is really interesting with the demo of the different chorus that Paul McCartney told them to change and everything. It just makes the song more interesting. So I'm gonna put that in B. Hump the Bump. I remember we really went off on that one.
Yeah.
But I must say I really like the chorus, and it's a really fun song live. Probably also B.
Yep.
Actually, high B minus. I don't know. I think it's worse than Power of Equality and Desecration Smile.
Yeah. For sure.
I Like Dirt is for me an A song. This is a song I never skip. I never skip it. It's just like finally a short song from this band, and it's like really energetic and everything, and the solo is really good, especially considering John was like recovering at the time, and his fingers were like hurting when he was recording the album. I think this is one of his strongest solos on the entire record, if not the strongest.
I think like I said, I think the second half of Californication is really good.
Exactly.
Compared to the first half.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think it's worse than Backwards, but definitely, in my opinion, more fun to listen to than If You Have to Ask.
Yeah.
Maybe not live, but when we just rate the studio versions, I think I Like Dirt is more fun than If You Have to Ask.
Yeah.
By the way, I think I put this one in A last time because this is like my favorite single from theirs.
Yeah. I think it deserves A.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm really critical of their singles because they're really overplayed, but this song is... First things first, this song is in drop D, which is... I don't know, I just really like it when the Red Hot Chili Peppers use a different tuning from standard. It's one of their heaviest songs, I think, because of the verses, and how it goes into the chorus is so beautiful. The songwriting of By The Way is really masterfully done.
Yeah.
I think it's a high A tier.
Yep.
They're Red Hot.
I mean,
maybe a B minus? Or like a
C plus? Yeah, the thing is, I skip this one a lot, but I think in the context of the album, it works really well because it's like the credits rolling.
Is, is that I like this song and it's catchy, but it's not good.
I mean, it's a cover and they put their own spin on it, so that's really cool. But I'm putting it in low B minus. I don't think it deserves the hate it gets. It's definitely not their worst song. That's reserved for Snow, but yeah, it's just not one of their best. Sick Love, definitely one of the better getaway songs, in my opinion.
Yeah, for sure.
The verses are really amazing. The chorus is kind of cheesy.
Yeah.
But all in all, I really enjoy listening to that one. When is Queen? Probably A+, let's be real.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, everything about the song is just so awesome, even though I have like clear favorites when it comes to the like second part is like my clear favorite out of the like this whole song. I don't know if you guys know, but this song was originally just called Epic. That was its working title. They have a song called Mini Epic, which is from their follow-up album to By The Way, which was never released. And that album was called Mini Epic because it has three parts, just like When Is Queen has three parts. And When Is Queen's working title was Epic, so that's a nice little fun fact to this song. Just because of those three parts, especially the second one out of three is like my favorite, and I think that's one of their like highest points in their entire career even. I think that's just so fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Definitely one of their best songs. Taste of Pain, definitely one of their worst songs. I don't know.
Kind of mid.
Yeah, this is like too long. It's a fucking 5 minutes long. But
yeah.
What we discussed last time is that this is the only track or DH is on a studio version, I think. There's an extended version on the Taste of Pain 7-inch or 12-inch, and that contains a version where DH plays on. I don't know if that's also on Mother Smoke or not, but that's a really cool fact about it. But all in all, I think this song is just kind of boring.
Yeah.
And Anthony's vocal performance in the chorus is like, I don't know. He could have had I like John's backing vocals. That's like the first song John ever like did backing vocals on.
Yeah.
This Ticonderoga, this is one of my favorite songs of them ever. Everyone agrees with me here, but I discussed it last time more in depth. This is just, I think this song is one of the most interesting they've done ever. I really like it when the Red Hot Chili Peppers go heavier, and this song really, especially on the context of The Getaway, where The Getaway is their softest album by far, then they just put out this banger, which then goes into this cartoony sounding chorus. Everyone hates on this song, but there's just something about it that, when I first heard the leak of The Getaway back like fucking 6 years ago or some shit, this was the first song I heard and I was really skeptical, but like now it's just like every time I listen to it I just get pumped. This is just, I don't know, this is one of my favorite songs. I really like Anthony's performance as well, because at the end he even does a little scream, and I really like it when he tries experimenting with his vocals.
Yeah.
Alright, Zephyr's song. Zephyr, you can...
So it's better than Scar Tissue. Have we ranked Scar Tissue yet? Or
nope, that was... comes later.
So I think Scar Tissue was like B, or B plus maybe, somewhere around that. So I think Zephyr might be A or B plus around that.
I agree with you. I think Life, it's definitely A minus. The studio version.
Yeah.
I think the studio version lacks
a high B
plus. What did you say?
I think it's a high B plus.
Yeah, me too. I think the studio version lacks a bit of energy at the end.
Yeah.
The live version has that energy, but Chad just kind of just taps his ride. Not that, like, I don't know, the energy is a bit lacking in the studio version, but live, it's really amazing. And I really like the song. This is definitely one of their best singles. Compared to what is playing on the bot right now. I have to skip this immediately. Alright. Mm-hmm. I skipped this one, but when I get around to listening to it, it's really fun. So I would put this in a high B minus.
Yeah,
maybe
I agree.
I like it more than Desecration Smile. So maybe B. So mid B tier. So Cheetah, easily one of the best songs they've ever done.
I agree. I love this song.
Amazing songwriting, really good musically. It's just, again, it's a bit long, and I sometimes still skip it. So I'm torn between putting it in A and a high A minus. I think for now I would just put it in high A minus, but maybe that will change later on. Deep Kick, I would actually, I enjoyed this song the same like Slow Cheetah. Yeah.
I'm not really a huge fan of this one.
I get why
if I'm being honest.
The intro is insane long. 2 minutes long, 2 minute long intro.
Yeah. But even after the intro, I don't think it's one of their best from 1 whole minute. Like, it's still good, but it's not one of the best.
I agree. Yeah, it's definitely not one of the best 1 minute songs, but there's just like something about, like, Anthony is really, really energetic in this song, so is everyone else. And I also really like the ending.
Yeah.
I don't know if you guys have heard the extended version of this song. Got leaked a couple of years ago. I don't know, I think every song of 1 minute is better than B+. But this is definitely one of the worst songs of the album. Oh Jesus, Force Lane, B plus. No, I'm kidding, this is one of my favorite songs ever.
Yeah, A plus, dude, I love it.
It gets so much hate.
Just so...
Yeah, dude, it's so good. It's so good, dude. This song, everything about this song is amazing. I don't know, the bass line is fucking crazy. The sub guitar playing, Jad's creative playing, the lyrics, the vocal melody, yeah.
It's a really beautiful song in my opinion.
I think this is their best slow song they've ever done. They have a lot of slow songs, but this is like by far the best one they've ever done. I'm debating if I like this more than this Ticonderoga. I think I like them just as much. These two might be like top three for me. I like album tracks now, not counting B-sides, I enjoy Eskimo and Time a little more than these two. But they're still like insanely strong songs. Midnight?
I love Midnight.
It's really good.
I don't know where to rank it. It'd be a hard one. B plus.
Yeah, high B plus.
Yeah.
You know why? It lacks the song. If you ever listen to the demo version, the song itself is actually really, really boring. Without the strings, it's a really boring song, in my opinion. The strings add so much to it, though, and make it a really special song. Just, it's again, the ending is just 30 seconds, a minute too long. But itself, I think it has a really beautiful vocal melody and everything.
Yeah.
It's a really one of their best ballads. And what
I
wish...
It has, I think it has, like, my favorite lyrics on our right song. Like, it's just good. I love it.
It's really good. What I really wanted them to do, even though it's like really unrealistic, but this would have been a good idea, especially for the stadium tour, and they have like so much money, they could easily arrange like orchestra playing a few songs with them as an encore, like, I don't know, maybe like Tangelo and Midnight and something else, maybe Road Tripping with strings. That would have been like a really good idea, but then again, the Red Hot Chili Peppers are really lazy when it comes to live stuff. But that's just my take on it. That doesn't really have anything to do with the song. Red in Time, I think this one is really good.
Yeah. I really like this song.
The bass line is amazing. And in the chorus. But I don't know about the verses, because I think what John plays... I don't know. I feel like the studio version is too slow of this song.
No, I was gonna say, I think the live version is way better, especially the scream at the end.
Yeah, the oh lord!
Yeah.
Yeah, the live version is much better. What's really interesting about the studio version, though, is have you guys noticed the backwards ending?
I have, yeah.
I'm still not entirely sure what he's saying there. I'll reverse it a few times. And I don't know if he says, like, we miss him or something with needles, but this song is definitely about Hillel. The lyrics are actually really, really good. So,
yeah.
I don't know. This song, I enjoy it maybe a little more than If You Have to Ask.
Yeah.
Which is kind of weird because, like, If You Have to Ask is like this monstrous song, like 5 minutes, and then there's just like this 1.5 minute rattle time, boom, boom.
Yeah.
Scar Tissue, I think we both agree that it's like low tier.
Yeah.
It's better than Californication because of the solos, especially Life.
I think it just overplayed and it got boring really quickly.
Yeah, yeah, it did get boring really quickly. I don't know.
Yeah, right there, yeah. Like,
yeah.
Every single time, put it below Zephyr's song.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know, this is just like, it's on the same level as Detroit for me.
Yeah.
I skip it a lot. Easily, on the other hand, I also skip, but when I come around to listen to it, it's amazing, especially the outro and the vocal melody, and this is like one of the most nostalgic songs for me. So, I'm gonna have to put this here, in my opinion.
Agreed.
Really good song, especially Life, it's a fucking, how did they not play this since 2004? Mm-hmm. Since 2004, it's been 18 years since they have played this song. They have brought back fucking Get On Top, but not easily. Like, why?
It's bullshit.
It's crazy. It's just crazy to me. And it's also crazy to me that there has not been a D plus song yet, but I feel like that will change very soon. Stadium Arcadium. Really good song, really good lyrics, really good vocal melody, which just, I just skip it every time, I don't know.
Yeah, I agree.
I feel like,
the second
I
gave this song, I used to, like, not listen to the song, I used to skip it, and then I gave it a chance, and I was like, the song is really good, but, you know, it's not the best on that album, but it
I
is
like
good.
It a bit
nice, like, melody.
I like it a bit better when it's played live.
Yeah.
I think I've heard it live.
They have not played it a lot, they've only played it like 30 times or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm not sure, I like Stadium Arcadium, but it's just like... It's one of those songs that you get into really quickly when you first listen to the Red Hot Chili Peppers, but once you are more familiar with them, you don't really listen to this song a lot anymore. It's just, that was my experience, and I feel like all of the fans that haven't really dug deeper into their discography put like songs like this and Wet Sand and Charlie and everything really on top of their list, but once they dig a little deeper, they like slowly like become less and less enjoyable for them.
Yeah.
At least that's how I think some people do it, and it's the same for me. Tell Me Baby, easily their best music video. I don't know, it's so fucking fun, that music video.
It's
really good. But the song, just really bad. I don't know, fuck Tell Me Baby. I don't know why they're still playing it. I hate it.
Yeah, it got boring quick.
Yep, I don't know. It's just a poor attempt of getting a funky song done on a rocky album. And the chorus is so cheesy. Oh my god, I don't know what they were thinking. I know really, whoever watches this video is probably really triggered at me putting this song so low down because it's actually kind of a fan favorite. But like, fuck this song! Why is it still on the set list? Okay, 1 Hot Minute.
I think it's in the higher range.
Yep. I like it more than Deep Kick. I like it more than Warp. No, I don't like it more than Warp. I don't like it more than Backwards. I like it more than I Like Dirt. It's an A. It's really long, but this is one of the only songs where I actually don't complain about the length, even though it's like 6 minutes long. And if we count the, I don't know if you've heard it, there was like this verse that was cut and was like also leaked a few years ago, so there's like an extra verse which makes the song like 8 or 7 minutes long. But nonetheless, I don't know. I just really like the song. I think it's really creative. They really went out of their comfort zone with this one. This is one of the heavier ones. I could. This is like almost a grunge song, almost.
Yeah.
Death of a Martian. I don't know. Maybe my one of my favorite choruses they've done.
Yeah.
But I don't like the outro.
I think I skipped a song most of the time.
A really good closer, though. For that, the outro kind of gets saved by the fact that this is a closing song. But that doesn't mean it's necessarily good. I don't know. I like it more than 21st Century.
Yeah.
Maybe even more than Power of Equality. But that's it. That's, like, very generous of this song. Even though there was a time where this was, like, one of my favorite songs ever. So I still really like it, and I'm really nostalgic for it. But, like, I just kind of got tired of it. And especially the outro, like, nowadays, kind of, I don't know, not ruins it for me, but it just makes me not want to put it into A anymore.
Mm.
Come On Girl, however, it's like, just because of that one performance at the Abbey Road with that outro jam, that's when the song really clicked for me.
Yeah.
Many people hate the song because of the chorus. They think it's really lazy. But I really like the chorus. Maybe here. I think that's a good placement for Come On Girl. I think this is... Yeah, okay. I think we stopped... ranking with Come On Girl because I don't remember ranking Charlie. I'm scared of ranking this one because this is definitely a fan favorite.
Yeah.
I think I wasn't a fan of it until I heard it played live, and then I really liked it when it was live, but I haven't listened to it since then, so I'm not too sure.
I put it in a low B minus.
Yeah.
Better than Scar Tissue, better than Detroit, better than Me and My Friends, actually. So it's a mid B minus. But it's just like another, like, if you listen to them a lot, like I did, for example, there was like a time, like 2 years, this is the only band I would listen to. And after such a long history with them, like, not even that long compared to others, but, like, I was really hyper-fixated on them for a bunch of times and for a bunch of long times. And, like, all these Stadium Arcadium songs just, like, gradually get worse and worse for me.
Yeah. I just kind of don't like this album.
Me neither. The outro is good, though. The do-do-do-do-do-do. I really like that part.
Yeah, I like that, too.
And also the Charlie... No, that part is also really good, but I don't know. It's just like I've heard it so many times that I would rather listen to, I don't know, Power of Equality than Charlie. Oh, Throw Away Your Television. This is an interesting one. What would you guys rank it?
I think in the poll that we're doing right now for By the Way, it got done kind of dirty.
Mm-hmm. Definitely. 100%.
B plus. I like the song a lot.
Yeah.
Maybe not B plus, maybe B.
Okay, my ranking is gonna shock you guys, but this is going straight to A plus for me.
That's fine, honestly.
I mean, the only reason why is because it's like another one of the energetic songs, and By the Way, and the outro, the Don't You Ever Leave outro they did in the 2000s, is like so fucking amazing. That's like one of the best things they've ever done. And like compare it, and like it's not even like that. That makes the live version much better than the studio version. It just adds onto the whole thing this song is. And I really like the abstract lyrics, and the effects John uses on his guitar during this songs are like or during this song is like, you know, it's just like crazy. I really like this song.
You know, this song goes by so quickly when you're listening to it too.
Yep. Just like 3 minutes. It's so good.
Yep.
I really like it when they try to manage, like, try to achieve something with the song for not 8 minutes, but only three. And this is a perfect example. The bass line is amazing. And it's just like, the bass line basically almost goes through the entire song. There's just like a few parts where it changes. Oh, this is an A plus for me. Okay. Nobody Really Like Me.
You know, I kind of like the song.
Me too.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah, I put this in A here.
I think that I'm a bit biased about all of these songs because this is my like favorite album, so it's hard to say.
For me, it's an A.
Yeah.
I like it more than 100. I don't like it more than backwards. I really like it. This is the only song. I think this is their heaviest song with These Are The Ways. And if I would be ranking Unlimited Love right now, I would be shocking everyone. But frankly, we're doing that at the end of the video, so. But yeah. Falling Into Grace. Oh, I really love this song, dude. This song is so good.
Too.
Dude.
Yeah.
High A. I cannot put an A plus because I don't want to overdo it, and I might take P down because it's not as good as the other A plus songs. But Falling Into Grace is fucking amazing. Magic Johnson. Oh my god. This song. Dude, I don't know. I don't know what it is with my unpopular opinions, but this is just another A plus for me. Actually,
no, I agree.
Because this is like a punk funk song almost from them. Because John does this funky guitar, but it's really fucking fast, and I don't know. It's like not even supposed to be a real song. They only ever tease this song.
Yeah.
But it's just like so fucking fun when you listen to it.
Yeah.
And it's one of the only Mother's Milk songs I never skip. I'm debating if I should put it on A or A+. I think I will put it on A just because they don't really acknowledge it as a song, but more like just as an interlude almost. But I still really like it. Organic Anti-Beatbox Band. With Backwoods, my favorite. Yeah. This is like... Again, I really like it when they try to do heavier stuff, and this is Hilo just fucking going insane on the E string, the low E string. I really like it. I don't know. This one, the Off The Map version of this song live is fucking great, but the studio version is awful. That's my take on it. I don't know.
Which song is that?
I cannot pronounce it. Homesick Blues. I cannot pronounce the first word.
Like Train in Homesick Blues. I think it's in the B area.
I would put it in B minus probably.
Yeah.
The live version is so good that if it wasn't for the live version, I would have probably put this in C. But the Off The Map version, everyone that has not checked out Off The Map yet, I highly recommend it. It's almost better than Slain in my opinion because the set list is so much better and their energy is really off the rails and it's not edited and everything, at least as far as I know, unlike Slain. It's really good. Torture Me? Bam. A plus. Bam. Probably one of my favorite songs ever. The Scream? This is the first time, this is like the only time Anthony actually tries doing an actual scream. This is like really fucking good.
Yeah.
Dark Necessities. This was like the song that got me back into the Red Hot Chili Peppers as a kid. When I heard this on the radio the day it came out, and I was like, oh my god. But I got tired of it, and I always skip it because I got so tired of it.
Yeah, I overplayed it.
I would put it here. Like, the song itself, I acknowledge that the song is really good, but it's just not, like, I don't, like, enjoy it as much anymore. And Mercury, also a high A.
Yep.
We'll put it here. No, actually, this song is so fucking good. The fucking ska song, almost. And
yeah, isn't it also at the poll right now too? Like you got voted off?
Yeah, I don't know what the fucking poll is insane
crazy.
Right now. Everyone that is watching this has watched like how long is this video already? 34 minutes. Everyone that got to this point, you should really join the server, please. We're doing a lot of fun activities, but the poll is so crazy. I don't understand 90% of the decisions.
Dost is still there, and I'm sorry for anybody that likes Dost, but...
we're gonna get to that later, because I agree with you, but we're gonna get to that later. I just want to say real quick, I have a really personal story with On Mercury. When I saw them their first time live in Zurich in 2016, or by the way, that legendary Nobody Weird Like Me performance is from on YouTube.
Nice.
Josh Goes Insane. I remember that was a fucking great memory. Anyway, this was the first song I heard when I went inside the venue, and it gave me such a warm feeling, and I have such a personal connection to this song. And I think a lot of others too. There's like at least three people in this survey that were called Mercury at one point.
I really
love this song. I don't know. There's not much else to say. There's like everything about the song is just so good. There's nothing bad about this song.
Yeah.
Breaking the Girl, I don't know, this is like another song.
Honestly,
that's
unpopular opinion, but I kind of hate the music video for this one. I think this one has a music video.
It's awful, yeah, the music video is awful. I would put it in high C+. I've not enjoyed it when I first got into the Chili Peppers.
I think that it should go in a low B-.
What did he say? A little bit higher?
In a low B-.
I could see it.
Yeah, actually, you're right. This song itself is really good.
I just think, like, seeing the music video into my head that I picture when I listen to the song, and yeah.
The thing I don't like about this song is that, the live version is lacking. Anthony doesn't sing a great life without the acoustic guitar. It's not that great without all the, what the fuck? Did you guys hear that?
Yeah.
That was fucking lightning. Holy shit.
Jesus.
Anyway, it's lacking life without the percussion and everything. It's just not that great. First D+ song, I don't know what to say about the song. The lyrics are disgusting. There's literally child porn in the music video. It's a fucking disgusting song, and I hate everything about it. And whoever disagrees with me, fuck you. You've sympathized with these actions. Okay. No, that was kind of over the top, but the music is alright, I guess. But everything revolving around the song is fucking disgusting. American Ghost Dance, on the other hand, is a really good one.
It is, yeah. I think one of the better ones off the album.
I'm just gonna put this above. No, actually, I enjoyed this as much as Black Eyed Blonde. I don't know. I really liked Anthony's flow on this one.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I see where we're going with this. Okay, this song is AC minus. I don't know. It's not fucking bad, bro. I don't know. The drums are so awful, and
yeah.
The only thing I like about this song, the only thing I like, which if it wasn't for that I would put it in D+, but I like it that Josh kind of uses distortion at one part and does it don 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 don. That's the only thing I liked about this song. Everything else is just maybe the chorus too. It is kind of pretty. For that reason, I put it in high C-. It's not that bad, but I still hate it. Ugh. Bro, this cup is also not good, let's be real here. There's a reason they've never played this song live.
Yeah.
Actually, they have. I remember checking and they've played it like twice or something. But it's just another taste of pain for me. Like, quality-wise, just like long and almost forgettable. Naked in the Rain. I'm sorry. I don't like this song. High C.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
This song is just kind of one of the fillers on Blood Sugar Sex Magik. Behind the Sun is probably one of the most interesting songs that I've ever done, just because considering who they were at the time and how they went out of their comfort zone to make this song, and how Flea said they've played it live once and it was so awful that they will never attempt to do it ever again. But the song itself is just kind of weak.
Yeah.
Probably high C plus. Yeah, I would put it in high C plus. That's Meet Me at the Corner. I'll put it high, like mid B plus maybe.
Yeah.
The bass line is really beautiful. Flea had the bass line before John left, actually, if I remember correctly.
Oh.
That's or just after he left. The fuck. Okay. So I think that's interesting to know. I don't know, like, I don't like the studio version. I love it live. And for the reason that it's so good live, I'm gonna put it in low A. Actually.
Oh yeah.
Probably A minus, actually. It's like just as enjoyable as you pick for me. She's only 18. Also a gross song. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's just the title alone, she's only 18.
Yeah.
It's just sad to see Anthony B like this. And I really despise him for doing what he's doing. But the song itself is alright, I guess, but just for that reason I don't really enjoy the song.
Yeah.
Probably around here. Cabron?
I'm not a fan of it, to be honest.
I really like this song.
I used to not like it, and then I've listened to it a few times since then, and it's grown on me a lot.
I think...
Yeah, it might just be because I've heard this song.
I think it's A.
It was A. If you asked me like a year or two ago, I would have put this in A easily. But I still got kind of tired of it, but I think it's one of the most fun songs they've ever done. Actually, for that reason alone, because it's just a pure 2-minute fun song, I put it in A. Pretty Little Ditty, that's like, if I remember correctly, that's the first song they've written with John. While the song that we made what we are today, the song that made us what we are today, I mean, that's like the first jam they did with John, but this was the first song they did with John, so that's interesting. This is difficult. I kinda like this song, but Butterfly ruins it for me. Butterfly is an awful song. Probably around here at Scar Chasing territory for me.
Yeah.
Funky Crime. I actually used to hate this song, but it's kind of grown on me because
I've always loved this song since I first listened to it. It's such a good song in my opinion.
I think it's really good, especially because when I started paying attention to it, I realized that the guitar riff in the chorus is actually really heavy and reminds me of some hardcore stuff, and for that reason I put it in D plus, maybe like
I can agree with that. Yeah,
did I, you know, oh my god, I love this song too much. Like, this is so good, this song. Down to the ending, this song is like, there's almost nothing bad about this song.
Yeah.
Holy shit, you've been recording for 43 minutes, there's still so many songs left, we gotta go quicker a bit. Okay, Wet Sand! Okay, I hate the song.
Here.
I hate the song.
Oh shit, damn.
No, I hate the song, sorry, everything...
No.
The reason why I hate it...
No,
yes,
no,
yes.
No,
dude.
No.
I hate the song because...
No.
I hate the song because of the... I hate it! I hate anything about it. Oh my god, every time someone mentions Wet Sand, my blood boils.
Two-part for this video. I'm gonna like upload this one part and then make a two-part.
Nah, I kind of see this.
Right,
I like kind of see what the fuck is. It's this. No, I kind of see this as a podcast, so like it's like almost kind of like a podcast. So I'll just upload it all in one.
Yeah. Okay.
No, the reason why I hate Wet Sand so much, it used to be my favorite song, then it got gradually worse for me to the point where I skip it every time I listen to it. Then I see all these mofos on the Red Hot Chili Peppers subreddit being like, this is the best song ever created. And I just think, fuck you all! And for that reason alone, because I'm fucking Rebel, I put it in D plus because fuck you.
No comment.
Tear or tear? I don't know. Is it?
I fucking hate. Okay, I hate the song's name so much.
I love it's tear or tear.
It. I think it's tear, but that word is just annoying to me.
Okay.
The song's good.
Yeah, tear is kind of. I think Chad said tear in the track by track. By the way, yeah. Why is it called tear and not tear? Like, what the fuck? Okay.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't know. This song is kind of too long, but I really like the. For that reason, I put it in. Here. Dance. I don't know. All right, song. Everyone really hates it. I don't know. It's not that bad in my opinion.
I hate this
one. I don't know. The bridge is all right. I know. I can see why everyone hates it, but I think I don't know. Maybe.
I think it's just the way that
he plays. Dance. Yeah, I don't know. For me, it's not that bad of a song. I still meme on it because it's definitely not their best and everyone hates it. Whatever. I don't know. Can't stop. Yeah, I don't know. It's just also just a song for me. It's not nothing special.
Sure. Yeah, I don't think the song has any, like, lyrical value to it, necessarily.
Yeah.
I mean, there are a few parts where you might be able to interpret it as something, but other than that, it's just, like, a...
The lyrics, "I am a watermelon," is in the demo, so...
I think it's just a song to kind of, like, groove to, I guess, you know?
It's fun to play, but...
Yeah, it's fun to play.
If you think about it, it's, like... If you think about it as a, like, as a song with meaning, there is none at this point.
No.
Wolf Trilogy. No, I'm kidding. This song is amazing. I really like this song. Actually, no. I just remembered the lyrics. My love is my dick in my hand. I hate you, Anthony! Just for these lyrics alone, I have to put it in B. The song could have been so good. It could have been so good. It's one of the... Arguably, I think this is my favorite live opener they've ever done with, by the way.
Yeah.
But the lyrics... Oh, come on, you motherfucker. Oh, Closer of debut album. Really interesting song. Sorry, I cut you off there. What do you want to say, Zephyr?
What was I gonna say? I don't know.
Lyrics something? Love Trilogy?
Oh, yeah, sometimes, like, Anthony's lyrics are insufferable. They're just, you question to yourself, like, why? Why did you have to do that?
Yeah.
Like, the song is so good with the fucking reggae part at the start, and then it gets faster. Granted, the studio version really lacks energy. Life, it's amazing. But then Anthony just screams, "My love, it's my dick in my hand."
Yeah, just.
I think this is a really atmospheric song. When I get around to listen to it, I'm really into it. But I have to be in the mood for this song, so I put it in around Charlie territory.
It's definitely something that you need to be in the mood to listen to. It's not that enjoyable.
But it's definitely their best musical composition. Like, musically, it's definitely their best of their debut album, I think.
Yeah.
Ernie wants a baby now. Just another song for me.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Low C plus, this is the most forgettable song, and I'm with you by a lot.
And this song came up for the lyrics, and I blanked on this song. I'm like, what the fuck is this?
Yeah,
I don't remember this song at all, basically.
The only reason why this song is less forgettable than Dance 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 is because Dance 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 is such a meme, and Anyone's a Baby is just whatever. Kind of like the bass line, but that's about it. Look, this is just another song. I really like the song. It has like a huge Hendrix vibe to it. But the fucking lyrics, what do you fucking mean? Blood Sugar Baby, she's magic, sex magic, sex magic. What the fuck?
Live, the song is really good.
Crazy. Absolutely crazy. Dave pulled it off better than John, just putting it out there.
He did, 100%, yeah.
This is exactly the same like Love Trilogy. I cannot put it above Love Trilogy. I'm putting it above just because the lyrics are still cringy, but a bit less cringy than My Love Is My Dick in My Hand. The Longest Wave, I think the entire community agrees that this intro is one of the best things they've ever done.
Yeah.
That's like the one thing everyone agrees with. The song itself is just like another beat here. It's alright. I actually kind of like Blood Sugar Sex Magik more now that I think about it. It's a really fun song.
It is fun.
I'm putting it on mid beat here. The Getaway. Okay, everyone kind of hates this song. I think I'm so nostalgic for this song for some reason. Every time I listen to it and I hear that chorus, I get like bombarded with nostalgic feelings. I don't know, I really love this one.
I like the song a lot, yeah.
This is like, with this Ticonderoga, my favorite, The Getaway song. I'll put it in A-. Oh, I forgot, dude. I did not forget about Annie Wants a Baby, but I forgot about Happiness Love Company. Okay, fuck you. This song is a C minus. This song is a C minus, bro. I don't know.
I remember this song.
It's like dan 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 dan. It's so boring. Your Little Turtle, on the other hand, really good, really good.
Yep.
Maybe my favorite from Freaky Stally.
Yep.
Also, just because the library is crazy good.
Yeah.
Actually, I'm putting Black Eyed Blonde in A- because this song is a crazy life, and I'm just putting Yertle here. Get on Top, I don't understand the hate, but I also understand the hate. Like, it's hated on too much, but I understand why, and I kind of agree with it at some parts. But the lyrics are so fucking funny that they're not cringe, like fucking Godzilla, Cuntilla, like what else do you want? Like, yeah. I remember when a user joined and leaked Tally and Outer Space and their username was Godzilla, Cuntilla. Yeah, it was a legendary moment. Animal Bar, one of the best in the stadium.
It is, it's so good. I've seen it ranked so low. What the fuck? That song is top tier Stadium Arcadium.
This is top tier Stadium Arcadium. I would argue I love this one more than Warped. More than Factory of Fate.
Yeah.
More than, by the way, not more than A Falling Into Grace Joke. That song is still very hard to beat. Okay.
Yeah, it is.
Higher Ground. I got so sick of this song.
Yeah.
And
good cover though.
It's a good cover, but I got so sick of it and I'm really glad they don't play it live anymore. If they would have played it live, it would have been below Tell Me Baby. I saw it live twice and the crowd was absolutely bored by it. Oh! Let's fucking go! I think this is probably my least favorite song of them. With Snow. I hate The Hunter. I hate everything about it. Most boring song I've ever done. Very, very poor. I understand the idea, good lyrics, but no, I cannot get around listening to it. It's just like 3 minutes long, but that's still too long for a monstrosity that is this song. I hate it. Danny California, let's go, another D+ song. I just can't stand this song.
Like, it got so old. First time listening to it, guitar solo at the end, like, that's fucking insane. Now it's like, oh, nah, it doesn't do anything for me.
Yeah, it's just like, I will probably put Wet Sand in C- just because I'm not that big of a fuck you guy.
Yeah.
Danny California, definitely D+. Good Time Boys. Everyone really loves this song. For me, it's just another song. Kind of forgettable. Really, really weird break in the middle with these random songs.
Oh, yeah.
Really fucking, like, what?
I don't like it. It ruins it.
It's really, really bad. Oh, shit, there's still so many fucking songs. We gotta do this quickly. Pokemon's out.
Server name.
Yeah, for that reason, I'm kidding. It's just like at the same level as Can't Stop, it's just another song. I understand why people really love it, but for me it's kind of filler.
Yeah.
Baby Appeal. Just another pre 100 minute song. I understand Life, it's really good, but Baby Appeal, like, I don't know. It's probably better than Behind the Sun. Walking on Down the Road. I still have this unreleased alternative take with an unreleased solo that I still want to release someday. Like, I want to put that on YouTube because it hasn't been put on YouTube before. But, I don't know when I'm going to do that. Just because of that, I think that song is a little bit more interesting. I kind of like this song. It's just like similar to Detroit.
I like it too.
So, Catholic School Girls Rule is my least favorite because it's so gross, but Snow is my least favorite musically from the entree.
Yeah.
Like, I just hate it. I got so old. Like, 2 weeks after I discovered them, I already removed it from my playlist because I started hating it. Ugh, I love triggering other fans. Okay, Green Heaven is probably A.
This song is my favorite song of all time. I'm just saying.
Did you listen to the live version in, like,
I have, yeah.
Where was it? Like, the 2000, I think that was in Mexico. Wait, or was that in Albuquerque? It was something with A, I think. I don't know, was that Australia somewhere? I don't know, I forgot. But the live version of the song is absolutely fucking insane because the John just does sex. Okay. Get up and jump. I really like the intro and the outro, but for some reason then they just ruin everything about it, so...
The one in Green Heaven with John going insane in the beginning is in Japan.
Yeah, that's the Tokyo one, but I know about that one, but there's one that I think that's even better. Wait, let me actually look it up real quick. It's like the only soundboard we have of it that's like really good quality, I think.
There's one in Melbourne.
Yeah, I think it was someone from Melbourne.
Yeah.
Because there were like a few soundboard. Yeah, it was someone from Melbourne. There were like a few soundboard audios they've released from that tour, and I got them mixed up.
Great song.
That John did in his like red hair.
Yeah, that's the Japan one. It's really good. Nevermind is amazing. Life. Wait, my internet is cutting out.
Yeah, it is. Yeah.
Especially with Dave. Dave kills the song more than John or Josh, and even Hillel for that matter. Dave absolutely kills it on this song. Life. Absolutely fucking insane. Studio version. The drums lack complete energy. I don't like the studio version. I always skip it. I put it in B plus just for the studio version. Actually, maybe here, just because the live version is like, I really wish they would put it in their set list again and close the show with this song. Knock Me Down. I really want them to play it live again. Because I feel like the song aged kind of badly, and if they would play it live again, that would make it a bit better. Because the song itself is really good. But when Anthony tried to sing it back in the 80s and early 90s, it was just kind of awful.
Yeah.
So... I think maybe B-.
I think it should be a bit higher than Get On Top if you're going to place it there.
I don't know. I think... I just skipped the studio version, and I think it it aged really badly because it was Anthony's first attempt of singing next to Behind the Sun. So
yeah,
I don't know. It's still a really good song though. Once you get around to listen to it, it's really fun. Probably like here. What is this? Police helicopter. Hey.
Yeah.
Right next to Green Heaven, because when they always play Police Helicopter right after Green Heaven. That's like their life thingy when they ever get around to playing Green Heaven. So I don't know. It's just really fucking fun. It's just like a little punk funk song.
Yeah.
Strip My Mind is kind of forgettable for me, to be honest. I know everyone loves it. I loved it too once, but now this is kind of eh. Probably tricking a lot of people because John sings on it, but frankly, I do not care. Tearjerker is the weakest song on One Hot Minute.
Yeah, I kind of don't like it.
I still kind of like it because I think it's a good ballad and it has nice lyrics, but it's definitely the weakest on the album.
It is. Well, the whole like almost ASMR thing that Anthony does in the beginning.
Oh yeah, that's kind of. Yeah, I don't know, man.
It's like, oh.
Like, can you turn up the track a little bit, please?
Yeah.
Emmett Remus. Wait, someone just joined to me saying that. Hello. By the way, we're. If you wanna talk, we're recording this. I should probably put this in the WC. WC name. Okay. We're recording ranking every Red Hot Chili Peppers song. Emmett Remus. This song gets hated on too much. I really like it.
I'll put that B because. It's an alright song, but lyrics are a bit weird.
I get that, but the thing is, the chorus is so energetic, and
yeah.
I really, there's just one performance in 1998 before the album released, where they played and everyone is like, oh my god, what the fuck is this song? But when the chorus kicks in, the crowd actually kind of like bounces to it, and I think that's really cool. That like changed my opinion on the song a little bit. So I would probably put it in. High B plus, that's just my opinion.
Yeah.
I get a little bit more than midnight. You're probably, just because you're just joined, you're probably going to be triggered by some things I put here. For example, Wet Sand is low C minus. Okay, Feasting on the Flowers.
That's annoyed me already.
Feasting on the Flowers. This is.
This song is one of my favorite of your
The thing about this song is,
not
that bad. I don't know. The song itself is weak, but the bridge is the best bridge they have ever done in their discography, in my opinion.
Yeah.
It's so amazing. I'm gonna put it in low A. Just the bridge makes the song worth not skipping.
All right. One quick question.
Yep.
Why is By the Way in A and not A plus?
Because I got kind of tired of it when time went on, but it's still my favorite single of theirs.
I think you put On Mercury higher than my friend normally does.
On Mercury is one of my favorite songs ever. It's really good.
It's good.
I would actually put it above Magic Johnson now that I think about it.
Oh, Magic Johnson's great.
Yeah, it's really good. If you want me to stay, I changed my mind. This is the best song on Freaky Styley, even though it's just like, kind of not even putting their own spin on the song. I still really like it. And this is actually Anthony's first attempt of singing, and I really enjoy it for that matter. So, A, I never skip it. What the fuck is this?
It's just a random image.
D+.
I think that if you leave it in the bit with all of unranked ones, then they, then it doesn't show. The shit on
yeah.
The end result and save the image.
Yo, Scott. Oh my god, no fucking way.
Yeah.
How did you even find this we see right now?
I was just scrolling through my, servers.
We're quite frankly ranking songs right now that you probably do not know, but you can still.
No, I've never heard of this.
The Skinny Sweaty Man.
What song's that? I can't really see the name.
Skinny Sweaty Man, this is probably.
Oh god.
Hey.
Maybe my. Life, it's probably my favorite song of Uplift Mofo, but...
This is why I don't see you in the other servers.
I know, I really rarely we see here, actually, but this is the only time we wanted to do for, like, fucking ages.
I mean, me and Sheep and the others were playing Gmod for a couple of days.
Dude, I was fucking... Okay, this is probably off-topic for people not watching the video, this is probably gonna be really off-topic, but I just want to mention, I remember being awake at 6 a.m. for whatever fucking reason once that I checked the WC and you were in the WC playing Gmod. Okay, let's go back to ranking.
That is great. That's just an absolute tune, especially the solo by John Frusciante.
Actually,
the song does look so nice.
If you don't at least put that in A, then I am going to be very angry.
You won't be angry because I just like it around here. It's a song that I usually skip because I also got kind of tired of it. But I really want them to play it again because that would be a nice change for once. I'm just gonna put this where it is. No, this is my least favorite with the Hunter of the Getaway. I'm putting this in C-. I hate everything about the song. There's frankly not one single thing I like about this song. I might just put it in D+ at this point. I don't know. My hatred of this song keeps growing. No, no.
Is that the song that was like,
Yeah, I hate it.
Oh, I it off my heart.
I thought it was the song I was playing right now.
No, we're just playing random instrumentals at them.
It sounds like it's looping.
Alright, is that for a new death song?
Yep.
Oh, that's a solid one.
Probably the best song from I Am With You.
Yeah.
I would change Did I Let You Know with Factory of Faith. And probably...
Faith is so good.
Probably here. But Brandon's death song is like fucking amazing. Almost Beats Falling Into Grace for me. Really good. Rain Dance Maggie, really good life, but studio version really forgettable. I don't know, C+.
Yeah.
It used to be one of my favorite songs.
Reading song, I really like instrumental, and Anthony agrees with me that the lyrics are kind of cringe, so kind of. I don't know.
See.
I like it more. I like it way more than it did in the rain, actually. But I like it more than Funky Monks as well. But it's just like here with Breaking the Girl.
Yeah.
You put Californication.
Yeah. I don't know. It's just like another one of those songs that you like 6 years ago when you first got into the band. And then you dig into the discography and then you're just like kind of eh. They have better things. I agree, I really like the bridge, but I think this is probably, with Make You Feel Better, the most forgettable song of the entire album.
Yeah, it is like really forgettable, but it's probably good. Like, don't.
I'm trying to not trigger you right now, but I just feel like, for the fact that this is probably the most filler song they have ever done, I'm gonna. Yeah, just because I feel bad listening to the song, because I think just that title alone is gross. Hello?
I feel so off being in this voice chat.
Well, we are quite frankly recording right now, so... This is Sir Psycho Sexy right now.
That outro is good.
I actually enjoy the parts before the outro more than the outro itself, especially like the off the map version is crazy good. I'm putting it here. Actually, I like it more than Slow Cheetah, and I really like it.
I'm gonna just probably head out. I don't know. I need to do some stuff anyway.
Right, I'll call you later on when we're done with here.
Sure, that's fine.
See you later.
Right, later.
Sir Psycho Sexy, the only problem I have with it is that the lyrics are fucking cringe, but it's so funny to see that all of the instruments stop when Anthony has to scream, "Now suck my dick," so... Storm in a Teacup, I actually really fucking like this song, I don't know, I like the chorus.
Oh, that is such a good song.
But the lyrics are like silly, but they're not cringe silly, like, put my dick in my hand.
It's probably one of the most underrated, probably one like... not the most generated song on Steady Markadian.
I think I can agree with that, because most of the good songs do get the credit they deserve, but Storm in the Teacup kind of gets hated on a lot. I like it more than Tearjerker and The Getaway and all of these here, probably. Universally speaking, I don't like this song anymore.
Oh, why not?
It's too long, it's too slow, it should be played faster, I don't know. It's just...
Yeah, well, you're wrong. You're wrong.
Yes. Yeah.
No, I'm not.
I do think it gets a little boring at some point, though.
But it's not C. It's not C,
I agree with you. It's better than all of these.
Or a high C plus.
Yeah, a high C plus is... I want your body on your pussy, baby. Cringe ass fucking lyrics. But the song itself is really good. But this lyrics want me to kill myself.
B minor,
I agree with B. Walkabout. Everyone loves this song really much. I think it's one of the weaker ones on I'm With You. But quite frankly, it's like the best album with Unlimited Love, so...
Did you just say about we don't I'm With You?
Fuck, I mean... It's... No, I mean, Wanna Admit It is the best album with Unlimited Love, that's what I mean.
Now,
I'm not sure.
I used to love this song.
Yeah, me too.
But now it's kind of falling off.
This is kind of falling off.
What
yeah,
we record it? Why? What is this recording for?
From a YouTube channel. We're just like,
what's your YouTube channel?
Just spec. You can probably find it. You probably saw one or two videos recommended before. What did he say?
I think I have the link somewhere.
I still can't hear you. Cut off.
This in your channel isn't like the massive. Is all one. Listen, tell me. Why is it just coming up with Roblox?
No, it's it has 490 something subscribers. Just search for spec or HCP. This is the place. Is,
okay, yeah.
Is
I have to list it.
I love the song.
Right.
Yep.
Yeah, found you.
Is this one also off the poll too? No.
Let me check real quick. Polls. If it is, then... Holy fuck, it is! What the fuck?! Okay,
that's
awful.
Good.
That's awful. But yeah, this is a place probably with Bob Mercury. Yeah, it's fucking good. Did you guys listen to the... it has a scrapped bridge. And it's really heavy with some distortion and muted strings. And I almost even like that bridge more than the original. I almost like this one almost more than On Mercury, but I think I still prefer On Mercury.
I instantly forgot what song we were talking about.
This is the place. But now it's Look Around. Look Around is just kind of forgettable again.
Yeah,
I kind of don't like this one.
Look Around, Look Around, I don't see.
Oh, Look Around is so good.
I don't know. Look Around. See for me.
Yeah.
You always sing the same, obviously A plus, no doubt about that. Look Around is for me high C. Actually, low C plus. Sexy Mexican Night.
Oh,
no, this one must be great. This one was here and I just accidentally put it there.
I don't really like Sexy Mexican Night that much.
Me neither. I'm gonna be honest,
yeah.
See.
I'd put it C minus for like a very high, or like the very high C minus, but C at like a first.
I actually like it kind of more than Taste the Pain. But it's not good. Warlock's really, really nice. Really nice song. But it's not like one of their best bangers ever. I'm gonna put it in low B plus. Around the World, probably one of their.
at the concert I went to, they played that, and I really passed out from excitement.
And it's, I think it's, I like it more than Can't Stop, just because it's a slightly rarer. But,
yeah.
Probably around B tier. It's one of my favorite singles of theirs. I really like the music video too. I don't know, it just has a nice vibe to it. Battleship? Battleship. Okay, I really like Battleship. The thing I listen to the most is probably like punk music. So this song kind of gets close to home. So just for that matter, I'm gonna put it just below if you want me to stay. Actually, it's not better than your other Hurdle. Why Don't You Love Me? Probably the worst cover they've ever done. C-. I kind of like the horns. Oh dude, I saw this song live. I saw this live and it was amazing. It was so good. Probably similarly, it's like, for me it's like a slightly worse Factory of Faith. It has like the same vibe to it. I don't know, I put it below Deep Kick. Actually, below Deep Kick, yeah. Aeroplane, I really fucking like Aeroplane. This is, with, by the way, my favorite single of theirs, with Warp also. These are like my three favorite singles. Also, no, actually, never mind, I forgot that Coffee Shop was a single. This is my favorite Red Hot Chili Peppers song of all time. And also, I'm just gonna not rank the obvious anything. But Coffee Shop is probably my favorite Red Hot Chili Peppers song ever.
Yeah.
I don't know, this is just like the best thing they've done for me. It's like, it combines what I really like what I usually listen to, and what they really like, what they usually do, like funk and fucking heavy and... amazing song, I don't know why people hate the song. It's amazing.
Yeah.
Dose, oh my god, Zephyr, let's fucking go.
I fucking think the song is a little cringy and overrated.
Yep, I agree.
No, it's like low tier, especially on. No, especially on. By the way, compared to like every other song on. By the way, that's way too high.
I think it should be a low B minus.
I agree. I think the chorus is kind of good.
Why is it good though?
The chorus is kind of good.
Yeah, it is.
Every part is good.
Nah, I think I don't like the verses that much. They get kind of competitive after a while. Like competitive, I mean repetitive. So. Yes, it's where is it? A tier for me, because it's a really fun song. True Men Don't Kill Coyotes. I think it's alright, yeah, B tier.
Should be a mid B.
Yeah, mid B. Yeah. I completely agree with you there. This is like the perfect mid B song. You turn it on when you want to, and you skip it when you go and listen to it.
Yeah.
Why the fuck is Goom Chuck a Bully playing on the bot right now? This Velvet Glove. Really good song.
Oh yeah, it's good.
High A. Mid A.
Yeah.
I like Animal Bar more. I like it more than By the Way, to be honest. Warm Tape. Ooh. Ah, this is almost A plus for me.
Yeah. Let me check something really quickly.
The live version of this song in Dortmund 2003 is absolutely incredible.
The song is also off of the poll, so...
Yeah, I like it more than This Is The Place, but I still think On Mercury is a little more fun.
Yeah.
Journey Again, this used to be my favorite song of all time for like a solid year.
The guitar solo at the end is probably the best they've ever done.
Yeah, that's the best solo they've ever done. But the chorus and the verses get kinda boring after all of those years.
I turn to you and then I turn into.
I don't like the vocals on this one, but for the solo, I'm gonna put it in higher B plus. I think I like it. Yeah, I think this is a good place to rank it. Transcending, okay, easy A plus for me.
Fucking A plus, dude. Yep. This song is great. The anger in Anthony's voice, the outro.
Dude, the anger in Anthony's voice. He described that perfect. This is fucking. This song is insane. This is.
Yeah.
One of the best I've ever done. And they've only played it live 8 times. Go figure. Suck My Kiss, fuck this song, I don't like it.
Oh, fuck you. Such a good song.
Suck My Kiss gets so boring after a while.
No, every time I hear it, I'm like, fuck yes, I love this song.
It's fucking 4.5 minutes long, dude. It's way too long.
That's what makes it good, though.
No, that's what makes it bad. If it was shorter, it would probably be like B. But if it's so long that I just skip it because I don't have the energy to listen to the same dun 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 for 4.5 minutes, so I like it more than Taste of Pain, Sexy Mexican Maiden, Naked in the Rain, for that matter. I know, that's what this video is for, and maybe just titled it pissing off every single RXCP fan. I actually kind of like this song, I Apache Road Peacock.
Yeah,
I do as well, I think it's a good song.
But it's not that great. High B, probably. Stone Cold Bush, oh my god, why is there a fucking porn sample in the middle of this song? Like, fucking fuck you, like, dude. That makes the song much worse. I cannot play the song in the car when my parents are there. It's just, why, dude? I don't know. I like more than Subway to Venus. But, more than, this is a high C plus for me. Police Station.
This song needs to be at least a B minus.
I agree. Not, I disagree actually.
Hey,
it's
so good.
I disagree.
Come on, at least
the lyrics are really good.
Yeah, but you have to put it so sad.
And the backing vocals from Josh as well, looks so good.
It's
Josh.
No, I said Josh.
It's better than.
No, it's... I said Josh, I fucked up.
Okay. Yeah, but like, right there, yeah.
Yeah. Funk Rock Classic, oh my god, this fucking song can suck my cock. Okay, Jungle Man.
Dude, I hate
this. Yeah, it's like every time. Are you talking about Jungle Man?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I think.
It's alright.
Jungle Man's actually, you know, not that bad.
But I mean, it's kind of like, oh, I'm a jungle man. It's kind of stupid. It's kind of stupid, but.
Yeah.
It's not good, but it's not bad either.
It's not bad. It's like C, yeah.
Alright, what have we got now?
Don't Forget Me. I think it's really good life.
Oh, they say that live to me. I'm not gonna back in the next album and like, bolt out instantly.
You went to the bathroom during a concert?
Yeah, I was pissing myself.
I don't know, man. I'm probably high B. Just because the song is really good life.
Yeah.
So, hold on. What did you say?
This song is really amazing life, but I feel like the studio version kind of lacks some of the energy they show off life. Especially the solo is really boring, I think, in the studio version. I think it's like low B plus, actually.
I think that the vocals are...
Yeah, I really like the vocals in that song. Hey, Buckle Down is also kind of like bare, like fucking, I don't know, just a bit better than Baby Appeal, maybe. Purple Stain, whoa!
Oh,
why didn't you remember the fucking... I put my middle finger in your fucking period blood. Fuck you! I don't know. I'm so torn. Just because I'm a drummer, and the playing the outro is actually so fucking fun. So, just below falling into grace. Mommy vs Daddy, disgusting song.
You know,
the solo is good, the instrumental is good, Anthony's a pedophile. I think that's a good way to describe it. Savior is really good.
I don't like it.
I think it's better than Right on Time, but that's about it. Parallel Universe, really good. Especially Life, probably one of their best songs. It used to be A plus for me, but now it's just A. Because
A.
I really overplayed it a lot. I like Purple Sane a little more. I wish I would have seen it, because when I saw them live, it was in the rotation. But like, I saw them live twice during the Getaway Tour, but they didn't play it.
Hey,
I'm gonna piss you off because I really fucking hate the song. I kind of like the bass line, but I think it's way too long. It's fucking way too long. It's 6 minutes long. Like, what the fuck?
You put Happiness Loves Company in C minor.
Yes.
Fuck you.
This is like the perfect D-minus here, right there. I hate him. 30 Dirty Birds, easily unrankable because it's so good. Other Side, D+. Sorry. Actually, never mind.
This song was the very, very first song I've ever heard. I think it has to be at least in the mid-tiers.
You know, the only thing I like about this song is the bridge. That's why I put it in C, but I despise this song. Dude, no, I think it's fucking corny. I think it's the corniest song they've ever done.
No.
The meaning, though, is sad.
I don't know. The meaning can be sad, I guess. But it's just so corny. The delivery is so corny. Fight Like a Brave. I don't know.
The bad thing about it is the music video, that's just weird.
Yeah, the music video is kind of weird. I don't know, put it like there. Fire, why, I don't know, it's so weird that this is on Mother's Milk. It's so weird that it's on there. But it's kind of cool life, so a high C+ probably. Dreams of a Samurai, easily the best The Getaway song with this Ticonderoga and The Getaway. I would put in A. Somewhere around here.
They're right there.
Yeah.
One Big Mob, A+ for me. Fucking amazing funk.
Yep.
This is the straight up funk metal. Fucking amazing.
Live would be like a better version of Me and My Friends.
This song live is like all the videos there are of this song live is just fucking insane. It's absolute insanity, this song.
Yeah.
I like Your More Than Torture Me. Yeah, this is like with Coffee Shop my favorite song. Shadow Beat That Game, fuck, also A+, like low A+, but
yeah,
this song is like also
yeah.
so fucking good. Make You Feel Better, low C.
I honestly don't remember the song, but yeah.
The only thing I remember about it is that Chad pitched his snare so fucking high. Monarchy of Roses, really nice disco rock funk.
B-, I'll put it high B-, B outpost.
I would actually put it rather low B-. It's not bad for any matter. It's just like kind of, you listen to it a few times and then you think, yeah. Mellow Ship has like fucking horrible lyrics. And his vocal delivery is so awful in this song. It's just like, I don't get why this song is a fan favorite, to be honest. It's just like a lower C+ for me. Freaky Styly is kind of alright, it's good life, but on the studio it's just kind of here. My Lovely Man, probably here. It's probably the best life song for them. This is the song that I don't get why they haven't played it since 2004. It's been 18 years. This is by far the best life song. Anthony can actually sing it. The solo is great. A lot of room for jamming. The jams are so insanely good.
The only bad thing about the concert I went to is that Anthony forgot a full list of Californication.
I mean, wait, doesn't he use a teleprompter? This guy is so fucking stupid. Okay. Especially in Michigan, it's kind of alright, I guess.
Yeah.
Kind of like B minus, like.
Mid B minus.
Yeah. Minor thing. Whoa! Yes!
High A.
High A, yeah, definitely high A. Definitely, I think I like it more than This Is the Place. I like it more than Warm Tape. I like it more than Mercury. This is like the fucking.
I think it's bullshit that all these like later, by the way, songs got voted off the poll.
Yeah,
the server.
Yeah. Fucking insane to me. Actually, I put this in A+ because the song is amazing. Okay.
I fucking love you.
Yes! Okay, We Believe.
That is a true E, Mike. Mid B, B, E.
I agree with you, B. But it's. I like it more than Saint Arcadium. I think it's a really interesting song.
At first, I didn't really like it, but then it really grew on me and I loved it.
Yeah, for me, it was, like, again, kind of the opposite, but I still think it's a really good song. Hollywood. Really, really good funk song, especially with the extended outro. This is, like, pure funk right here. But I'm not really that big of a funk fan, so I might just put it in. Low B+. Johnny Kick a Hole in the Sky, like, I don't know why, but this is just fucking high A for me. This
the start
is...
of it is a bit weird.
No, okay, yeah, the singing, yeah, but the bass and the boom, 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 boom. Insane.
I like the start of it.
Yeah, I kind of like it too. It's still a bit weird, though.
It is weird,
first of all, I fell asleep listening to Red Hot Chili Peppers, woke up to that, I full on thought, that is not Red Hot Chili Peppers. I didn't like it whatsoever.
You know what my biggest problem with this song is? They had an original chorus for this song. And it's so much better than whatever they chose in a final version. Why the fuck did they choose some weird ass? Like, the song is slow and quiet enough. And the like original chorus was more upbeat. They played it during the I'm With You tour. And I just don't get it. It had... so much more than potential that what it eventually came to be. Dude, I'm fucking tired of the song, I'm sorry.
No, fuck you. Fuck you.
I'm sorry. I'm tired of this song.
It's so good.
The only reason why I like this song is because of the live jams, and they don't even jam this song live anymore, so like, fuck this song. Loving and Touching.
Mine.
Goodbye, Hooray.
So good.
This was my favorite song with Turn It Again at first when I first discovered them again, but now it's just like kinda eh. I like it more than Dance Dance Dance, at least. Road Tripping, good acoustic
good.
Ballad.
Yeah.
John with the acoustic there is so good.
Same probably. Energy as the Jello, obviously.
Yeah.
Like, maybe here. My Friends, also my favorite single. All the 100 minute singles are fucking insane. I don't know. Dude, I don't know what they thought when they picked every other single, but the 100 minute singles are literally so amazing. All of them.
Yeah.
I would put it like here with the other three. Did you guys know, by the way, that Child Be That Game was a single in Australia? Okay.
Alright, what's that?
Back. Hard to concentrate.
Oh, that is so good.
It's kind of alright. I will put it here with all the other.
Yeah.
Singing, recording songs. I could have lied. Probably the one of the better ballads. I would put it in A minus. High A minus.
This song
probably.
This song I had an obsession with for a bit, and it's still my top song on the it says on the FM bot, but I'm sick of it now.
Yeah, I had kind of an obsession with it as well, but I still think it's a really good song. No Jump or Soccer, actually, never mind. This is probably my favorite Uplift Mode for Party Plan song. I really, really enjoy this song with Backwards. I think it's really good. So much I really want them to play live again, but they don't enjoy the studio version that much. Probably one of the better singing songs. I put it in B. Under the Bridge, you're gonna hate me for this, but it's just a C plus.
Yeah, it also
grew old
on me,
though.
Yeah.
Like,
when I first heard it, I liked it, but then it just,
it's cool.
I just didn't like it after a while.
I'm just gonna put all these songs I cannot rate in D plus. So, this picture too. Okay, I will actually put this image above the pedo song. Okay! So, this would be the tier list for now, but what we're gonna do now is we're going to also rank the Unlimited Love songs. Black Summer would, I'm just gonna like do this literally so cheaply.
I think it was good at first, but it got like bad.
I actually really like it. I think I like it.
Yeah, like it's good.
I like it more than did I like, you know, actually I think I really enjoy that song. So this is Black Summer. next song on the album is I think Here Ever After, right?
Yep.
Probably also A for me, even though I got tired of it, but I think it's like around here.
Yeah.
Next song is Aquatic Mountains, right?
Yeah.
Also A tier for me. I love every single Unlimited Love song. I think there's
I think that maybe a high A, a high A minus or a bottom.
I don't know if I agree with you because I got kind of tired of it because they played it so much live.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
The bass line is amazing.
Yeah.
I don't know. I like it more than Facing on a Flower, so. Oops.
What's PA?
That's Here Ever After. Oh my god, not the one. Yeah, I thought not the one.
I don't like that.
Not the one was originally, in my opinion, the worst song they've ever done.
Yeah.
But I can tolerate it now. I think I like it more than Turn It Again. It kind of grew on me.
Yeah, originally it was kind of like it was bad. And then I listened to it, and in the context of the album, when you listen to it. It works really well.
Originally, I was so mad at this song. I thought this was gonna be the worst album. I was so fucking mad at, like, I was, I was ripping this song to shreds. But now I don't really mind it anymore. What's after Not the One? Is it Great Apes or is it something else? Oh, Poster Child. Yeah, everyone kind of got tired of the song, but not me. It actually grew on me, and I actually like it more.
I don't like it because it's just a bunch of like.
I think it deserves to be a single, in my opinion.
It wasn't really a single, it was just a promo track.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't know that.
I enjoy it more than The Getaway, because it's really catchy. It's like too long, but it's still kind of like, it gets into your head a lot.
Yeah.
Now is Greatest Apes, and I think we all agree that Greatest Apes is A+.
It is A+, yeah. That's solo.
Yeah.
It's not The Great Apes, it's just The Great Apes.
Oh yeah, The Great Apes, sorry. Yeah. Fake fan.
Yeah.
But yeah, the song.
Shake,
I would put this just below Minor Thing. What's the next song?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm trying to remember.
It's
Only Natural.
This is like,
I remember when we had the listening party for the leak, and I heard this song. It was fucking incredible.
This whole listening party was incredible.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, A. You know,
yeah.
In my opinion, it's only natural kind of sounds like if they did a follow-up album to Stadium Arcadium with John.
Yeah.
Because it kind of has that, he kind of plays the solo in the style he did when he was soloing back in the 2007 tour. Like, it kind of really reminds me of his playing from back then. Wait, I gotta like mark this bit better.
My next one is She's a Lover.
Wait, I still need to rate, It's Only Natural.
Yeah.
I like it probably here.
Next one, Days of the Ways.
Yeah.
Really?
She's a Lover.
After Natural?
Well, it's She's a Lover after Natural.
Oh, okay. Dude, fucking incredible. Dude, fucking incredible song. I love this song to death.
Plus, dude.
I don't know if they put it A plus. I think I would put it very high A. Not over on Mercury, but over Warm Tape. This is saying a lot because this is their newest album, but it's been like 3 months since we first heard it. So this is like crazy that I still have these like strong opinions of it. So These Are the Ways.
These Are the Ways.
Okay, guys, I need to confess something. For that ending alone, it's my second favorite Red Hot Chili Peppers song. This is gonna trigger a lot, but this ending is, I think, the best thing they've ever done in their entire career. When we first heard it in that listening party, there were approximately, and I checked, there were like fucking 300 messages within 60 seconds. It was absolutely insane. Fucking insane.
When that outro went off, dude, holy fuck.
That was like one of the craziest experiences in my life. Next song is, What You Thinking?
That's alright.
I like it more than Brandon Stuff song, so I'm just probably gonna put it here. And I'm gonna type it like everyone fucking types it. What coup? Okay.
Next one is Bastards.
Bastards of Light.
Dude, also A plus. I cannot believe this.
Agreed.
Bastards of Light is fucking amazing. I like it even more than this Tacona Roga. I'm not a country fan at all, but the fucking bridge of this song is, Anthony has so much anger in his voice that he hasn't had since 1 Hot Minute.
That vocal distortion is
crazy, absolutely fucking.
That's what
good.
That's what made me love the song.
Yeah, the bridge is what makes the song. Then they go into that really fucking hardcore riff, that hardcore punk riff.
Yeah.
Fucking amazing, dude. What's the next song?
One Way, White Braids.
Okay.
White Braids? Fuck! Also A plus! Oh my god.
It is.
Such a good song.
That outro is. Yeah.
Oh my god, I'm just.
Great song.
I remember when we listened to this Acha the first time, everyone together, and there was a smell in my garden, and it was so fucking. Dude, this whole listening party was so insane. This
it was.
Outro
it was
means.
Best, like,
yeah. This outro means so much to me that just thinking about it makes me want to cry because it just makes me remember the time from like the time in the server pre-release and the listening party. What's the next song?
One Way.
One Way Traffic.
Probably one of the weaker songs, even though I really like it still.
Oh, I love One Way Traffic.
I think it's really good, but one of the weaker songs of this album. I think it is still A tier. I think it's low A tier.
I can agree.
Next song?
Next one is Veronica.
I've said that to Max.
Veronica. I don't know, also one of the weaker songs.
Yeah, I think the outro is good, but waiting the entire time for the outro,
yeah,
gets...
I would just put it just above one. Actually, you know what? I think
I don't know how you pronounce it, so yeah.
I think they're like on the same tier almost.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then we got Let 'Em Cry, which in my opinion is an A+.
At first, I would have agreed, but I'm not sure. Let 'Em Cry, I haven't listened to it in a long while. It's a really good song.
Neither have I, actually. I'm going to listen to it right now.
This is difficult. I really fucking like the horns. That's a really good part.
I'm going to find it first, actually. I've got too big of a playlist. Alright, here we go.
Okay, I would put it just above, by the way.
Yeah.
Next song, is that already Tangelo?
It's Heavy Wing.
Oh, and Tangelo after this one, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I really... I hate on Heavy Wing a lot because I think it's insanely overhyped just because John sings on it, but it's still A+ for me.
Yeah. The guitar solo is fun. It's a fun solo to listen
really
to.
Yeah, really good. I think I like it more than Menace Queen.
Yep. Also one of the longer songs, but it doesn't feel that long.
No, it doesn't feel long at all. It's like...
Yeah.
Really good. Now Tangelo.
Yeah.
Also,
I think Tangelo is a better closer than Road Trippin'.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tangelo is also A+ for me.
Mm-hmm.
It's like... Just... Actually... I would put it... I don't know. Tangelo is fucking amazingly beautiful. I would just put it just below the Great Apes. So this is the very beautiful tier list.
Not as beautiful as you.
Thank you. But I put Wet Sand in low C minus, so...
Fuck you.
I can't show the whole thing in one screen, actually. So yeah, this is it. This was... How long is the video? 2 hours. It was really fun.
Yeah.
Ranking
it was
all of us.
Fun, yeah.
We should do an album ranking if this video like gets
some traction. I need to
keep
doing halfway through.
I actually really enjoyed that you joined. I think it's good that everyone gave their own input. I know I talked a lot, but that's just because it's kind of like, you know.
I like your voice. It's soothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, we should do an album ranking now.
I'm just gonna, this is like fucking, wait, okay, how do we want to call the, okay, come, no,
the top tier is just to come, shit,
alright,
that's so aggressive.
Let's start with Bloodshaker 6 Magic. For me, it's just kind of good.
That's right. By the way, I'll put it in good.
I think I'm coming.
Yeah,
me too. Caravan came good.
Yeah.
Freaky Stylish, bruh.
I'm with you.
Bruh. Oh, yeah, kind of bruh, to be honest.
Bruh.
Mother Smoke.
Nope.
Kind of bruh.
Yeah,
Stadium Arcadium, kill yourself.
Fuck off.
The Getaway, kind of good. Kind of good.
I fucking hate you.
Uplift Mofo, good. Unlimited Love, best album they've ever made with One Hot Minute, kill yourself. Alright! That's it, everyone. Thank you for sitting through 2 hours of
fucking hours.
Oh my god, this is crazy. Awesome.
You know, I had woken up and I saw the ping, and I was like, shit. I woke up late, I woke up at 12, so I've been, I woke up and I started doing this.
Oh, this is really fun, though.
Beck, I hope you know I've lost all respect for you now.
That's actually good, because I want to show you something.
What are you going to show me?